Hi, we're Girl Scout Troop 50102, and we're here to show you how to make a rehab bird basket cover for the Wildlife Care Network. To get started on this project, we use a box that is 16 inches by 13 and 8 by 10 inches. For fabric, we used old sheets. Any size is fine. Next, we cut out a rectangle using a ruler, a mat, and a rotary cutter. The cut size is 33 inches wide by 21 and a half inches tall, and it looks like this.
Step one, fold in half the mark the halfway point with a pinch. Then open it up and measure 6 and 75 inches from the middle and mark it. So we're gonna fold this from the corner tip down, then we're gonna fold back and find the mark. And once we find the mark, we put an extra little mark on the outside. Then we hit the ruler and put it right against the line and mark a straight line all the way across, and then put three pins on the line. And the same thing on the other side. Then get this. You look here again. You find it, you mark it. Take your ruler and drop it right now. And
today I'm going to show you how to straight stitch a basket cover. First, you have to remember to put the foot up. Then you put the foot down. You have to remember to do this or else it will not work. So I'm back stitching three. Oh, okay. And now I'm going to continue stitching. Oh. And when I get close to a pin, I'm going to take it out and then keep going. Oh, stuck. Remember to keep the fabrics smooth so there are no bunches. And now I'm gluing a pin again, so I'm going to take it out. Put it there. Now I'm going to take this pin out. And now I'm at the end, so I'm going to backstitch again.
Okay, so this is the step where you have to zigzag. Now, So first you have to turn your sewing machine on. Set it to, for me it's 4, it's supposed to be zigzag. And so you unfold your cloth. As you can see, it's already straight stitched, so that means that I just slip it in. So the straight stitch is along the left side of the foot. Put your foot down and start sewing. And don't forget to backstitch. So you just go along with your straight stitch pretty close to the foot. And you just keep doing it, and then you get to the end. Backstitch again. And stop at the end, lift up your foot, lift up the needle if you have to. Trim the string. Always put it behind the sewing machine. Trim the extra string if you want. So now it's like this, as you can see. And so now, as you can see, I've done this. And now you just do the other side. And repeat, do the same exact thing. And after you do both of those, you want to cut. And so you want to cut about a finger away from the zigzag. So it doesn't have to be that exact, just not too far, but not too close that the zigzag will come undone. And you just cut right alongside. And it's done. So as you can see, I've already cut and zigzagged along the straight stitch. And so it doesn't have to be that exact, which is the good thing. So really any beginner sewer could do it too.
This is the cover and it's ready to be hemmed. So first I'm going to fold this about a half an inch to right there about, and I'm gonna start at the corner. I'm gonna put the foot down. And yeah. So corner. And I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna fold this and this so the other side is folding over it, and I'm gonna pin it to make sure that it stays. And then I'm gonna slip it. So I'm gonna go a little bit slow as I near it, as I'm nearing it. And I don't want to like sew in the thing, so I'm gonna take it out. I'm gonna slowly do it. And then I'm gonna make sure the needle's down. I'm gonna lift the petal, or the foot. And I'm gonna down the foot, and I'm gonna start sewing again. And I'm gonna do the same with the other corner. So, yeah. As you can see, I hemmed it all the way around, and the hemming step is finished.
Now let me show you how to slide it on the box. Like this. Now let me show you how the cover keeps the bird protected.